Hi! Today we're going to show you how to make a camera shake effect using the latest version of VSDC. We already published a similar tutorial a few years ago, but a lot has changed since then. So let's see how it's done! First, let's switch to the Prime Workspace mode. Next, add your footage to the resource window or directly to the scene. In the template window, start typing Shift and drag the effect to the scene. Double-click on the effect, then find X Shift Levels. Open the template menu below and select Sinusoid. Now you can use our values or set up yours. Here are our settings, for example. Minimum curve value, negative 50. Maximum curve value, 50. Frequency, 140,000. Similarly, find Y shift levels and adjust the parameters as well. Minimum curve value, 50. Maximum curve value, negative 50. Frequency, 140,000. Great! Technically, the shake effect is ready. Now we want to add a bit of motion blur so that the effect looks more realistic. Go back to the template window and search for blur. Then drag the motion blur effect to the scene. Select the effect on the timeline. Find blur distances and open the additional settings for this parameter. Then open the template menu and select sinusoid. Again, you can use our values or set up yours. Here is what we've used. Minimum curve value, 0. Maximum curve value, 40. Frequency, 50,000. Find blur angles and adjust the values as well. In our case, it's minimum curve value, 0. Maximum curve value 360, frequency 50,000. The shift effect and the motion blur create a great combination. However, you may notice the black background on the sides because the frame is shaking. This one is easily solved. In the template window, type zoom and drag the zoom effect to the scene. Then find levels and increase the value so that the frame covers the entire scene. By the way, you can always make the scene borders visible using so-called paper tools. And it's time for the cherry on top. Select all three effects on the timeline and hit the cross sign in the template window to save this combination to your library as a new effect. Now you can add another video to the scene and apply the custom shake effect you've just created in one click. So this is it. This is how you create new effect templates for future projects. Hopefully you liked this tutorial. Make sure to give it the thumbs up and subscribe. If you have any questions, let us know in the comments below.